Hello everyone, good morning. It's a fun time to start making any presentation on Friday morning. So I'm Kasim Mohammed. I'm from Linaro, working in our developer services team. So my talk today is on Chromium OS and trying to analyze if Chromium OS is the best operating system for these next generation IoT devices. Okay. So to give some background and introduction on the topic, back in 2000s when I was part of this industry, so we had classified these electronic devices into like some devices which fall under laptop and desktop and servers kind of thing, and then we had very low-end mobile devices at that time, and then the remaining things were all called as embedded systems. So any hardware platform we are going to use, so basically it used to be categorized as embedded system hardware. And today if we map that and if we look at where we are, so we do have a server and notebook and laptop and these things as one market, and then we do have smartphones and tablets and these things in another market segment, and then we have the IoT devices. So basically what started as embedded systems, today we basically are forcing it to get into something like IoT devices, because almost all devices are now connected to internet in one way or the other. So again, in that, if we want to classify, the IoT devices are classified into two things. Now, one which directly collect the data from the sensors and push it on internet, and few other devices which collect the data but also do some kind of processing and also have some kind of display and do run some kind of algorithms to do some kind of minimal data processing before pushing the data on cloud. So the IoT market is big, vast, and we cannot generalize this statement. So we need to identify what areas are we going to cover with Chromium as an operating system. So what matters is in IoT device, there are two key factors which are very important to note. One is the user experience of the device, and the other one is the benefits that it offers to the end user. Like if we are giving an IoT device to an end user, so how does he interact with the device, and the experience of interaction should be much, much better. And the second thing should be like the benefits that it offers. Once you collect the data from the IoT device, what are you going to do with the data, and how you are going to present the data, and how you are going to analyze the data, that is also quite important. So what benefits it offers, and what kind of user experience it's going to give. So in order to do that, in order to have a very good user experience and to show some real benefits of the end product, it is supposed to have very good connectivity. The product should have multi-layer security. I say multi-layer because it's not just the device which needs to have the security, but also the communication, the data communication should also have a good secure protocol to follow. And as usual, like the other things are like the power management, whether it is wall powered or battery powered, the device should have good power management. And there should be an option of running machine learning and artificial intelligence algorithms today, because that's becoming a need of the hour, where some kind of processing has to happen on the data before pushing the data into cloud. And then the amount of processing power that device would really give, and this end product should meet the standard and certification to make sure like it is falling under the required regulations to make it an end product. So all this is possible only when we have a right hardware and also an appropriate mixture of software stack. That's why I mentioned here, like all these things has to be blended fine to give us a perfect software stack and the hardware product to make this IoT experience a better one. As I was saying, like the IoT device segment is quite vast. If I say like Chromium OS for IoT device, we cannot generalize it in a very broader sense. So we have to identify what areas we are going after. So the stack that I have written here on the left hand side is not something new to everyone. So it is a known stack where we have the end IoT device on the top, which is basically collecting the data from the sensors. And this could be microcontrollers or it could be any other high-end SoC based device. The data collected from that is actually sent to a global network. It is sent to the controlling device. So the data can be on cloud and then can be used by the controlling device. So I classify this into three different areas. One, where the data is actually generated, and second, where the data is analyzed or processed, and third, how the data is presented with all the right statistics and things. So all these three areas should be covered in the stack. So when we say Chromium OS in IoT device, where are we actually trying to push it? Are we going to push into the end device, or we are looking at Chromium OS as controlling device? So as you can see from the picture, we are definitely not looking at Chromium OS in controlling device like notebook or tablet or something, because it's already there, and we can write applications to make our phones or tablets or notebooks as a controlling device. So that's already there. What we want to do is get Chromium OS onto the actual IoT device, which is collecting the data and processing the data. So that's where we are actually getting the Chromium OS into. And if you see the kind of applications which can where we can get Chromium OS running, so as you can see in the right hand side of the circle that we have, so there are plenty of IoT devices in the market today. So not all are fit for Chromium OS. So some of the devices, like if you consider entertainment devices like a television, or if we consider automotive devices, they have very well defined software stack. So we don't want to get into those markets. So we have very good software stack for auto, very good software stack for TV and set-top box segments, and we have good software stack for different applications, and also microcontrollers, where it is a very simple device which is just collecting the data and pushing on cloud. So even there, we don't want to look into those things for Chromium. So the other areas which are highlighted with a check mark here, where it could be an industrial HMI, or it could be an automotive non-automotive device, but it could be some kind of entertainment device. Basically, wherever we see head or headless device, where there is a clear need for security, connectivity, web applications, and some kind of high-end UI, and with decent power management and such things. So all such devices can easily have Chromium OS running into it. Again, to make my stand very clear, when we say Chromium OS, we immediately try to compare it with any Linux distribution. Like, we try to immediately compare it with Ubuntu, or we try to compare it with Windows 10. Definitely, for a given market, like if I am looking at laptops or something, Ubuntu or Windows 10 might be much better, and it is definitely the right operating system to go with. And when I am comparing smartphones and these, then definitely Android and other iOS kind of things are much better compared to Chromium OS there. But what we are trying to do here, we are not talking about those markets at all. We are looking at Chromium OS as a replacement for existing Linux or other stack in IoT device, which is non-controlling device, but the actual IoT device. So why Chromium OS? As I said, like, there are definitely a lot of alternatives for us from an operating system point of view. So we have free Linux distributions, which are Yocto and OE build based. We do have commercial Linux vendors and who are supplying a fine-tuned stack for these kind of end devices. We also have non-Linux distributions, which can definitely is definitely available for IoT devices. But Chromium OS actually is a very, I would say, like, very nicely populated and pre-integrated open source software stack, which is built on mainline Linux kernel, and it has all the basic, I would say, ingredients which are which makes IoT device experience a much better one compared to any other operating system. So in this next slides, what I want to emphasize is like, how do we, how the IoT device would look if we pick Chromium OS as an operating system, and is it feasible? Like, if we take Chromium OS today, will we have a better IoT device compared to what we would do if we pick any other operating system? So just imagine your next IoT device with Chromium OS. So today, if I build any IoT device with a standard Linux distribution or any other operating system, then the UI, the user experience which I am going to give, the kind of configuration facility that we would give, the amount of security we could give in the device versus what we could get if we use Chromium OS as an operating system in that device. So kind of trying to imagine that what kind of benefits we might offer into that end IoT device that we would make. So the first advantage if we pick Chromium OS compared to any other standard Linux distribution. So coming from a Linux background myself, I always find it very difficult if we have to fine tune a given Linux distribution to a particular domain or particular product segment, because like if I am doing OE or Yocto build or any other Linux distro build, you will have to find, first of all, you need to decide what exactly you want from the software stack itself. So there are so many browsers available, there are so many windowing systems available, there is different kind of database stacks which are available in Linux distro. So you need to pick and choose which will be the ideal thing for you. And at end of the day, you also have to see they meet your memory requirements, like the end image that is it's going to generate, that part, and then which kernel version to pick, and what tools to use, and what SOC to use, and if that SOC is supported or not supported. There are so many things which you need to list down and figure out before actually getting into doing the prototyping part. But if you see the Chromium OS software stack, it is, as I said, it is very simple, and though it is based on Linux kernel, which is also coming from mainline, the rest of the components which are stacked upon Linux mainline kernel is very neatly defined. And since it is already into production into millions of devices on Chrome and notebooks, this is also giving a well validated stack for us to deploy it on any kind of IoT device. So definitely this is one of the key advantages, I would say, to make IoT device production ready, or make prototyping faster and also get into production faster. The second advantage that I see, or second differentiation that we would get if we use Chromium OS in any IoT device, is the graphics stack. So there are plenty of new features which are added in Chromium OS. So if we build an IoT device using Chromium OS, we would be able to leverage all those rich graphics user interfaces or rich graphics user features into our end application. Like, for example, we can have some kind of translucent effects, we can have multi-window effects, we can have random or runtime orientation changes for our end application. So all these features are readily available in Chromium OS, and if we write a web application on top of it, then we can straight away use it. And also, the stack actually offers a good multi-touch experience also, and the touch latency is much reduced with the latest stack compared to the previous stack. So that is one value add that we can bring into IoT device. The next key feature is the network and Bluetooth stack itself. So Chromium OS, by foundation, it is built for networking. Like, when you launch the Chromium OS, it comes up with a browser. So when it comes up with a browser, it is much more fine-tuned to work with the network compared to any other operating system. So there is a lot of optimizations and customizations which have been gone through in network stack to give a much better user experience with respect on Chromium OS. So few key features which we can always look at is, like, for example, if you have an industrial setup where you want to deploy multiple IoT devices, it is no different from a classroom having hundreds of Chromium, like at least 50 Chrome notebooks in one classroom, which is all connected to a common hub and user playing with similar web applications in all Chrome notebooks. So that use case is already validated in one segment. So taking that use case into any other industrial segment where you want to deploy hundreds of Chromium OS running IoT device may not be difficult to do or difficult to achieve. The second thing is, like, the with the latest stack, New Blue for Bluetooth, the drop rates and any kind of Bluetooth device in any profile like A2DP or AVRCP or HID, all these things are much improved and they give much better user experience compared to the previous Bluetooth stack. And again, the other Linux distributions are still using the older Bluetooth stack, but Chromium OS is on the latest Bluetooth stack, which will give a better user interface. And also the latest technologies which are available for web applications. So earlier Bluetooth or NFC or USB were not available to web applications, but today they are available. Today we have interfaces like web USB, web. Today we have devices like web USB, web NFC, and web Bluetooth, which will bring these devices to a browser. So using the browser, we can control these devices and get the data. So if I write a web application, I am able to access these devices from the web application. So this is one of the key advantages. Apart from that, the security layer is much well advanced and much well established in Chromium OS. So there is multi-layer security, as I was saying. Not just the data communication is secured, also the product, end product itself is secured. So you have verified boot, you have data encryption features, which actually make the product more stable and secured, along with the sandboxing facility where in web app, if it has some kind of malware or something on particular window, then that doesn't actually affect the application running on another window. So each web app is treated as a separate entity by the operating system. So an application, if it fails, then it is not going to affect the another application, so which is very much essential in a multi-layer application. Also on the storage part, like as we know, it is mainly Chromium OS is mainly targeted towards cloud application or cloud based data processing and pushing the data on cloud. So they have support for SQLite database and LevelDB, and also like the data encryption and decryption options for file system. So and also like the multiple partition facilities which are available in Chromium OS to make the product more secured. So we definitely can easily solve the slow access to data as well as abrupt power failures. They are not going to affect the data as well as some kind of data corruption. So these three issues can be addressed easily compared to any other Linux distro. And there is very good presentation on this on YouTube, which you can go through from the Chromium engineers on this. So next key things are, one is the web apps. So we develop an application on web, which can be easily carried out to any other device, like your, so manufacturer writes one application on one device. So same application can be carried out to n different devices and no need to change anything underneath for running an application, and because it is running on web app. And also the new progressive web app, they are very much need of the hour, I would say, because it allows you to install application runtime from backend and on the browser. So these kind of features and functionalities can be easily used in the next generation IoT device. Along with that, we the complete Chromium OS setup itself, the way you download the operating system, the way you port it to a new SOC or a given hardware, and to do some kind of minimal customization, and to even work upstream, like if you have some made some good changes, you can even go push the changes to chromium.org. So all these things are very neatly written and captured on captured online, and there are tons of materials out there, tons of videos out there on YouTube which you can go follow. So that makes your developer experience very very good, and then it is also easy to work on. So I would say like Chromium OS is much easy to start with or begin with compared to any other Linux distribution for IoT devices in particular. So finally, to conclude, as I was saying, there are the IoT devices is a very vast segment. First of all, we need to pick and choose on which device Chromium OS is going to fit. Second thing, we have to move the developer who is working on IoT device to spend time more on his own issues and innovation than focusing on solving Linux distro issues and making sure getting a pre-populated Linux distro. And also, it is our responsibility now to make sure the IoT device is actually using the latest and greatest of features available in the market on other devices, like we are using gesture or orientation or graphic stack or different network facility, web apps, progressive web app. All these things are such latest features which can also get into IoT device, and it can give a much better user experience on IoT device compared to the old single slide kind of applications. And also security and power management and AI and machine learning algorithms, all these things can be easily integrated into a pre-well-defined Chromium OS stack compared to any other distro, I would say. So, but it is definitely possible to do whatever I spoke just now. So all these things can be achievable, and it can be done with any other Linux distro. But doing it on Chromium OS is much easy, and it is much faster, and it will definitely give a better user experience on IoT device. So this is what I had, and I'll stop here if you have any questions. Thank you.